Mr. President, I'd like to pick up this Armageddon theme. You've been quoted as saying that you do believe deep down that we are heading for some kind of biblical Armageddon. Your Pentagon and your Secretary of Defense have plans for the United States to fight and prevail in a nuclear war. Do you feel that we are now heading perhaps for some kind of nuclear Armageddon? And do you feel that this country and the world could survive that kind of calamity?
Mr. Calvin, I think what has been hailed as something I'm supposedly as president discussing as principle is the result of just some philosophical discussions with people who are interested in the same things, and that is the prophecies down through the years, the biblical prophecies of what would portend the coming of Armageddon and so forth, and the fact that a number of theologians for the last decade or more have believed that this was true, that the prophecies are coming together that portend that. But no one knows whether Armageddon, those prophecies mean that Armageddon is 1,000 years away or day after tomorrow. So I have never seriously warned and said we must plan according to Armageddon. Now, with regard to having to say whether we would try to survive in the event of a nuclear war, of course we would. But let me also point out that to several parliaments around the world, in Europe and in Asia, I have made a statement in to each one of them, and I'll repeat it here. A nuclear war cannot be won and must never be fought. And that is why we are maintaining a deterrent and trying to achieve a deterrent capacity to where no one would believe that they could start such a war and escape with limited damage. But the deterrent, and that's what it is for, is also what led me to propose what is now being called the Star Wars concept, but propose that we research to see if there isn't a defensive weapon that could defend against incoming missiles. And if such a defense could be found, wouldn't it be far more humanitarian to say that now we can defend against a nuclear war by destroying missiles instead of slaughtering millions of people?
Mr. President, when you made that proposal, the so-called Star Wars proposal, you said, if I'm not mistaken, that you would share this very super sophisticated technology with the Soviet Union. After all of the distrust over the years, sir, that you have expressed towards the Soviet Union, do you really expect anyone to take seriously that offer that you would share the best of America's technology in this weapons area with our principal adversary?
Why not? What if we did? And I hope we can. We're still researching. What if we come up with a weapon that renders those missiles obsolete? There has never been a weapon invented in the history of man that has not led to a defensive, a counter weapon. But suppose we came up with that. Now, some people have said, that would make it war imminent because they would think that we could launch a first strike because we could defend against the enemy. But why not do what I have offered to do and ask the Soviet Union to do?
First of all, let me sharply disagree with the President on sharing the most advanced, the most dangerous, the most important technology in America with the Soviet Union. We have had for many years, understandably, a system of restraints on high technology because the Soviets are behind us. And any research or development along the Star Wars schemes would inevitably involve our most advanced computers, most advanced engineering, and the thought that we would share this with the Soviet Union is, in my opinion, a total non-starter. I would not let the Soviet Union get their hands on it at all. Now, what's wrong with Star Wars? There's nothing wrong with the theory of it. If we could develop a principle that would say both sides could fire all their missiles and no one would get hurt, I suppose it's a good idea. But the fact of it is, we're so far away from research that even comes close to that, that this director of engineering research in the Defense Department said to get there, we would have to solve 8 problems, each of which are more difficult than the atomic bomb and the Manhattan Project. It would cost something like $1 trillion to test and deploy weapons. The second thing is, this all assumes that the Soviets wouldn't respond in kind. and they always do. We don't get behind, they won't get behind, and that's been the tragic story of the arms race. We have more at stake in space satellites than they do. If we could stop right now the testing and the deployment of these space weapons, and the President's proposals go clear beyond research. If it was just research, we wouldn't have any argument, because maybe someday somebody will think of something. But to commit this nation to a buildup of anti-satellite and space weapons at this time, in their crude state, would bring about an arms race that's very dangerous indeed. One final point. The most dangerous aspect of this proposal is for the first time we would delegate to computers the decision as to whether to start a war. That's dead wrong. There wouldn't be time for a president to decide. It would be decided by these remote computers. It might be an oil fire. It might be a jet exhaust. The computer might decide it's a missile, and off we go. Why don't we stop this madness now and draw a line and keep the heavens free for more?
In this general area, sir, of arms control, President Carter's national security advisor, Zbigniew Brzezinski, said, quote, a nuclear freeze is a hoax, unquote. In your view, which specific weapon systems could be subject to a mutual and verifiable freeze, and which could not?
Every system that is verifiable should be placed on the table for negotiations for an agreement. I would not agree to any negotiations or any agreement that involved conduct on the part of the Soviet Union that we couldn't verify every day. I would not agree to any agreement in which the United States security interest was not fully recognized and supported. That's why we say mutual and verifiable freezes. Now, why do I support the freeze? Because this ever-rising arms race madness makes both nations less secure. It's more difficult to defend this nation. It is putting a hair trigger on nuclear war. This administration, by going into the Star Wars system, is going to add a dangerous new escalation. We have to be tough on the Soviet Union, but I think the American people
Time
and the people
up,
of the Soviet
Mr. Mondale.
Union want it to stop.
This invention that has just been created here of how I would go about rolling over for the Soviet Union, no, Mr. Mondale, my idea would be with that defensive weapon that we would sit down with them and then say, now, are you willing to join us? Here's what we can, give them a demonstration. And then say, here's what we can do. Now, if you're willing to join us in getting rid of all the nuclear weapons in the world, then we'll give you this one so that we would both know that no one can cheat, that we've both got something that if anyone tries to cheat. But when you keep star warring it, I never suggested where the weapon should be or what kind. I'm not a scientist. I said, and the Joint Chiefs of Staff agreed with me, that it was time for us to turn our research ability to seeing if we could not find this kind of a defensive weapon. And suddenly somebody says, oh, it's got to be up there and it's Star Wars and so forth. I don't know what it would be, but if we can come up with one, I think the world will be better off.
Well, that's what a president's supposed to know, where those weapons are going to be. If they're space weapons, I assume they'll be in space. If they're anti-satellite weapons, I assume they're going to be made armed against anti-satellites. Now, this is the most dangerous technology that we possess. The Soviets try to spy on us, steal this stuff, and to give them technology of this kind, I disagree with. You haven't just accepted research, Mr. President. You've set up a strategic defense initiative, an agency. You're beginning to test. You're talking about deploying. You're asking for a budget of some $30 billion for this purpose. This is an arms escalation, and we will be better off, far better off, if we stop right now, because we have more to lose in space than they do. If someday somebody comes along with an answer, that's something else, but that there would be an answer in our lifetime is unimaginable. Why do we start things that we know the Soviets will match and make us all less secure? That's what a president's for.